It's no doubt that Uganda's export volumes over imports have been dwindling over the years as the country struggles to build a robust industrial system to boost production. This means that with the current 3,000 industries, the total output cannot accommodate the needs of the 34 million Ugandans. According to the Presidential Advisor on Finance and Planning, the focus should be channeled towards increased production to meet escalating demand.
They may need more land, need more inputs, like fertilizer, maybe more equipment, maybe some kind of machinery, aside from the hoe. And of course they need capital in order to buy that equipment and to get storage facilities and so on, and transport. So I hope that somehow we don't forget that export is also about production. We can't export what we don't produce.
Seruma argues that limited skilled human capital remains a huge challenge for Uganda, coupled with the high cost of private sector credit that limits investment opportunities. But the State Minister for Economic Monitoring attributes this to failure by agencies to market Ugandan products. He cites an example of Chinese goods which continue to flock the local market.
Where are we buying the, where are these iron bars coming from? Where is mint coming from? Everything. We are using Chinese money, using Chinese products. Then what does that tell you?
He adds that strategic interventions to boost exports remain unclear as Uganda seeks to move into a middle-income state by 2020. Top government officials from the Office of the President now say fast-tracking Vision 2040 export initiatives will be important to enable Uganda remain self-reliant to a bigger percentage. Reporting for Urban TV, I'm Simon Oktala.